Hello and welcome, Paul here, and I'm playing Floris, a mod for Mountain Blade Warband. Now, we're currently at peace with all the factions, so I'm just trying to put my time to good use. I'm here with this patrol. I'm hoping to turn him into a super patrol, basically give him a ton of troops, and we're just going to send him to Sunno or somewhere. And the idea is that, you know, he basically grows into this monster unit where I can just send people. You know, I just have extra troops to send to various castles we take. So right now we're in the desert because there just happens to be a ton of bandits here with a ton of prisoners to rescue. So that's the plan. I want to do something stupid. No, I can't. I wanted to like run over this hill and dive into the middle of him, killing someone as I do it, but they quickly were on the hill before I was. You know what's funny, or what's weird? So, when I started playing Mountain Blade Warband, the longest time I was using, you know, to attack from the right, because I always found it easier to hit, but I was starting to get to the point where this like backhanded swing from the left just, I don't know, just feels better. And I guess it's not really anything to talk about, but it's just, I don't know, I've played so much Mountain Blade and I kind of get used to things, and change like this is kind of big for me, so I just figured I'd let you guys know. I mean, at the end of the day, I'm just killing these dudes, so, you know, it's either me shouting, run them down or something, or try and, like, describe some of my thought process about things. I wish I could wear what he's wearing. I don't know where to get his gear. Swadian guards, man. Traitors. So we just rescued a ton of people for them. And their patrol has grown. Really, we're looking for that patrol which has like 2,000 troops and 400 guards. Sorry, 400 bandits and 2,000 troops, or 1,900 bandits and 3,000 prisoners. Either will do at this point. Ready to fight both. We need more food. Lord Kramak is here. Splendid. All right, come on. Go after him. I'm right with you, mate. I'm right with you. Go after him. Fight him. Fight these lot. I don't care. Just pick some. Who is over here? Man, 1,300 troops there. That would be a fight, mate. Yes, get captured. No, yes. We'll let a few more jump on. Now I jump in. I didn't want to do too many because what will happen is, well, I didn't want to let too many come too close because if I wasn't careful, they were just going to bypass them and go after me. That's happened like a whole bunch of times when doing things like this. I don't know who I blocked then. I blocked someone. Jesus. Jesus, man. Serious now. Remember, push through if this ever happens. Oh wow, I got completely messed up. I was throwing off my game, couldn't get in the groove. Oh well. It is literally no big deal. Let the enemy charge upon my archers, or my infantry. My archers will probably do the rest. Ooh, well, we are taking a few hits, but these, most because they're like rank ones, so... Tell you what, let's back out. Let's restart it. There's only 200 of them. Archers are in an excellent place here. My infantry isn't standing in front blocking them, but they are protecting them, so this works out quite nicely. So it's like have all my cavalry and infantry just stand down in this little basin. My archers up top can safely attack. Yeah, like so. And they keep coming to a full stop because horses are just like being left, you know, unmounted and stacking up, creating some sort of wall barrier type deal, so this is quite nice. See what I mean? And we're doing pretty well. Is that Borcher? I thought Borcher left. Or was it Rolf that left? I think it was Rolf. There we go, they're dying pretty good. Archers still have plenty of arrows, I don't think too many enemies have come by thus far. This is working pretty well. unless the horsemen get past them, like that. But most of them seem to be archers. It's a mix of lancers and archers, and the archers will just turn off and, like, go in for a second swoop. So the lancers I gotta be careful of. Very good. Very good. That's another win. That's another tick for the win column. I didn't lose a single person as well, I might add. Let me go ahead and upgrade who I can. We're probably going to need them fighting fit here in a moment. Now, if I leave these guys in the field for too long, what will happen is they will... I don't know, they'll disband. The last time they disbanded because there was no money, it was weird. We'll see. I'm going to do a similar tactic here, although we don't have the terrain. But there isn't many of them. Go for them, have fun. That was the guy throwing rocks at me. I had to take him out. Luckily they're not going for me anymore. Mostly not going for me anymore. Except for these guys. Okay, I'm falling into the trap of not moving forward. I didn't want him to lance anyone, because he'd have done some serious damage. One? Almost. Oh, they got me. Oh, I guess I'm not feeling it today. Anyway. We've almost won this. There was only like 100 and something odd troops attacking, and we've almost cut through the majority of them, so... My patrol's growing as well, which is good. New enemies have arrived. Good, send them over. Send them over. So yeah, my patrol has about 700 troops. There is another enemy bandit with 1,300 troops coming up, but we'll have to, you know, fight them, rescue everyone, and I believe there's one more desert patrol out there somewhere with so many prisoners for us to rescue. Whether or not we'll find them, I don't know. I may just send these troops to go to one of my castles, maybe Tulga, so I can focus on capturing stuff this end of the map, maybe Dirim because it's starting to get low. I don't know, but we'll work something out. Anyway, the enemy is getting mobbed at the moment, which is good. The enemy's weak enough, I could probably just change my warband around a little bit so I don't even use my archers and just send my cavalry out. My cavalry is very strong. Oh, I actually lost two people that fight, but instantly replaced them with rank 7s. Feels good. So that knocks the patrol up to 1,100. And as you can see, oh, look at these guys, 200 with 800 prisoners. Look, mate, why are you running? Why are you running? Look at you. Oh, there we go. That was the patrol I was talking about. Okay. So these guys have got 2,300. He's got 800, 700, 2,000. So this is a serious amount of prisoners to rescue here. We just need to, secure this win. Yeah, fight him, mate, fight him. I could wait for the enemy to get close, but just for the sake of, you know, taking these fights, because the others are gonna add like 1,000 troops, not like a few hundred. It's gonna be 1,000, which is gonna be pretty extreme. I've actually got quite a few cavalry out here fighting away, so we'll just go in. We're going for the kill. I really can't wait for Bannerlord when I can, like, construct my own sword. That's gonna be insane. Have a sword for every occasion. Okay, infantry push up. We ain't doing much back there. Let's push up to their spawn. I'll try and see how this works with enemies this numerous. Can we, like, lock them down at spawn and just cut through them very quickly? That'd be worth a try. So we're gonna attempt it with these 200 odd troops at the moment, which isn't bad. Okay, you're mine now. You are mine. Where's the enemy spawn at? Right there. Let's try this. The way we do it is to bring everyone over here. I need my archers in position because they're the ones going to be doing the majority of the damage. Yep. Get impos. Okay, as they get settled in, we'll continue this next time. So thank you for watching. Be sure to join me then. Cheerio.